Hello and welcome back. This is Frost Terror. What's going on, guys? We're playing some MLB the Show tonight. It's Father's Day. It was a decent day in general. It was not a It's some family stuff today that was not the best. But my wife is asleep early tonight, and I'm just doing the only thing that I can think to kind of just, you know? Oh shit, Ronaldo. I forgot my heel was hurt. Fuck. I guess, sure, you're up, rookie. It's a great fucking lineup. Gotta play Gabby. Grichik in center though is bad. I gotta put Carroll there. Grichik to right field. Like almost immediately.
Welcome to Ready to go? This is Corbin Carroll.
I don't know, just, you know. So, I'm not going to talk very much today. We're going through it, you know. Going through some stuff. Energy games just helps. Helps,
In the air, out to center. Crow Armstrong should have it.
Give you something else to think about, honestly. It's like a
time to
deflection.
Take a look at the Diamondbacks lineup.
It's okay.
Chris, this is an offense that puts the bat on the ball. Tough outs pretty much throughout the lineup. And they have fewer strikeouts than any other team in the league.
Yeah, Boog, and I just remember as a player, when you're going up against a club like this, it keeps you on your toes all game long because you've got to make plays for your business on the defense. And so an offense like that can really put some pressure on that defense. So they can swing the bat, put it in play, but I also think if they run the bases hard, it adds another element to their game.
Two down, nobody on. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. You rewind and think back to those Giants teams that won 3 world titles. They were pretty good contact-based teams. Obviously, the Royals as well. It feels like it's swinging back a little bit towards there's an advantage to having some hitters in your lineup that make contact. Up the middle, and it's through for a hit.
There we go.
Joey gets on base and keeps it going. And now it's the polar bear, Pete Alonso.
He's going.
Here's the pitch. Runner goes. And a foul ball. Walker, the runner at first, two gone. Runner goes again. And a foul ball, he stays alive.
You keep going inside, or you're gonna go outside.
Kershaw fires. Runner on the move again. For the second. Out there. And now Freddie Freeman.
Got two lefties today. Nice. Snell. I'll play Snell. Gotta play him. At this point in time, like the Dodgers, like the Diamondbacks, they got to sign someone or something.
A 977 OPS, 29 home runs, and more than 100 RBIs. That's a great season.
They've been doing a great job. Last couple games, the offense has been keeping afloat, but you can't do that. You gotta get guys back.
Swings through that one out in front that time.
Trade for someone.
One out, base is empty.
They're like just like doing bullpen games like every other day. That's not sustainable. See what Snell's got with this curveball.
That one not close. And it's 2-2. And there's a ball.
3 balls. 2 strikes.
One down, base is empty. Foul we'll see another payoff pitch. Eighth pitch of the at bat coming up. Inside ball four. It wasn't easy, but he earned that walk after a long at bat. One gone, runner at first. Here's Mookie now.
Just... if it were an average catcher behind the plate, I'd say take second base, but this isn't a catcher you want to run on. His quick release is unreal.
And Mookie takes.
Mookie broke his hand today.
And at first, one away.
Corbin Carroll got hurt today. It's just a... it's just a day, man.
This one in the dirt. Runner holds, and it's a full count. And now the lefty. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
Two walks in the first has to be some cause for concern. I mean, you're talking about a guy you want to pitch deep into the ball game. It's not going to help with the pitch count right there.
You just can't find the strike zone.
They can't afford to hand out three bases at this rate.
Comes up empty. That's strike two.
The last thing he wants is to hit the ball on the ground, but I wouldn't expect many pitches up in the zone. They'll be pitching for a double play in this spot.
Runners at first and second with one gone.
He's a bad ball hitter, so even if you get him to chase pitches outside the zone, he still might beat you. Not an easy out by any means.
Left-hand batter waits. He fouls it off. We'll do it again.
Why does it seem like it's easier for them to...
here in this first inning, I mean, you're giving the other team a really good look. He's going to have to find a way to get some weak contact.
Almost 30 pitches in the first inning.
Get into that dugout and hit the reset button.
Two on, one out. And they're all loaded up. That's a great at bat. He saw a lot of pitches and earned a walk. And up to the plate is Will Smith.
When you go that deep into an at bat, the hitter usually comes out on top.
At the belt and fires. Next offering popped in the air, right field. No trouble here, puts it away for the out. And there are two outs.
Well, they're really running up the pitch count in this first inning. Lots of confidence from this team that is perhaps the hottest in baseball right now.
Now it's the right fielder, Nolan Jones.
Definitely got the hitter conscious of the pitch inside. Really,
that got it.
He swung.
And that's gonna force in a run.
That's bullshit. He swung at that.
Bases full. And next for LA, Teoscar Hernandez. And the 3-1. Ball four, and a run comes in to score.
He's really gotten himself into a mess out there, and now forces home a run with the walk. This inning's definitely getting away from him.
Here's Kike Hernandez. Fastball for a strike.
Looks like he's just sizing him up there.
Just
really good pitch
right
to hit, but he took it all the way. Sometimes guys just want to set their timing later on in the game. That may be a pitch that he turns off.
Two outs. Got him! Huge strikeout there. No hits for them in the inning,
sucks.
But they're gifted a couple of runs. On to the second now from Dodger Stadium. It's the Dodgers 2 and the Diamond. Back here
four
in
walks
LA,
and a hit by batter.
Started. Here's some real power at the plate. Pete Alonso. And he walked him.
Oh, okay.
After scoring runs, this is where you're looking for that shutdown inning. Get that hot team back in there to swing the bats.
Randall Grichuk now. And a pitch. Ground ball left side could be two. To second, there's one. On to first, double play.
Got what he was looking for on the mound right there, and his infielders took care of business. Pretty textbook execution between short and second to turn that into two outs.
Headed down the line.
Just
and that's a foul ball. Kershaw deals. And a pop-up, right side, foul territory. Freeman makes the catch.
It's your shutdown inning.
Back here at Dodger Stadium. Digging in, it's the speedy outfielder, Pete Crow Armstrong. And another ball. Singy, he wasn't real sharp in the first. Got hit around, but really more so. Didn't throw a ton of strikes.
Well, he's just got to find a way to settle down. He was clearly fighting himself out there. Not really finding the strike zone. Walking batters. So we'll see if he can get back on track and fill up the zone a little bit more.
Bounce to the right. Alonso. He takes it on his own and about quickly time. One away in the second. Freddie Freeman up to the dish. Swing and a ball driven pretty well out towards left center. And there's two down. Gavin Lux steps to the plate for the Dodgers.
Maybe he'll be like those other pitchers where you have like a bad first inning and you only get a run or two and then he was dominant the rest of the game.
There's a swing and a miss.
In this situation as the number two hitter, two out, nobody on, you want to be a table setter. Work the at bat, get deep, whatever it takes, get on first base.
Two outs, base is empty. Got it by him for the K.
66 pictures in two innings. Nothing to it. Fucking
out
brutal.
Of the third inning, Brandon Drury to the plate. The why to kick the pitch. Swing and a miss. That's strike two.
Fucking filthy, man.
Ripped to third. Throws across the diamond. One up, one down. Here's Garrett Hampson. One down, base is empty. On its way to the corner, on the move towards foul ground. Nice grab on the run. And there's two down. Gabriel Moreno stands in now for the Diamondbacks. Line drive, base hit down the line.
There we go.
So the two-out knock extends the inning and sends them back to the top of the order. So the lineup flips over. Corbin Carroll stands in now for the Diamondbacks.
Two ball, one strike.
In the dirt. Well done behind the dish.
Mm-hmm.
Two outs. That one misses. And a count is 3-1.
Head back to the desert.
So now two one and two outs.
Pretty easy walk right there. That last pitch wasn't even much to think about.
First and second, two down. Here's Ketel Marte. On the ground to the left. And that's just foul. Though Chris through the early stages, he hasn't been very efficient in terms of the pitch count. He's going to need to get some quick outs if he's going to get deeper into this game. That one kicks away from the catcher. It is interesting, though, when you consider the way the game is run now, doesn't even matter that much if your starter doesn't go that deep because teams are really aggressively building their bullpens. Outside low. Counts full, 3-2.
I'll take a walk and let Christian Walker bat. Bases loaded.
Base hit, one run is in. Another comes in to score. It's 2-2.
Well, there you go. The RBI machine. Another clutch run scoring it back.
Yeah, he's been so good in these situations. Call it clutch if you want, but his resume speaks for itself. And now, Christian Walker. Smoked into left, base hit. Throw
perfect.
Stops the lead runner at second. Two on and two out.
Well, that'll make you feel good as a hitter right there. Just a solid swing right there. Caught it out front and ripped it into the outfield for the base hit. Those always feel great.
Here's Pete Alonso. Line right drive. Out. Come on.
Damn. I want him to go for the last half of the inning.
Mookie Betts will get us started. Outside. And now 3-1.
You know, these Dodgers showing great discipline at the plate, and patience definitely seems to be the name of their game in this one. The numbers kind of speak for themselves with the four walks. They've done a great job of not trying to do too much and just staying disciplined.
Got him swinging. Here's Max Muncy, that funky Muncy. And a swing and a miss there. Got him looking. Fastball to Letters throws him for strike three. And here is Will Smith. The 1-2. Good job to fight that one off.
Back foot slider.
Two down, nobody on. And down on strikes. And a nice inning of work there as he's. And we're back. And now the right fielder, Randall Grichuk. Randall Grichuk. Misses the zone and he gets him to chase.
My man's just throwing in the dirt, basically.
That one out to right. Fair ball.
Nice. I'll take it. As a leadoff hit, I'll take that.
Here's Lourdes Gurriel Jr. That one way inside. Strike two.
The two strikes may see some movement over there at first base, trying to stay out of the double play right here.
Run around the move. Swing and a miss. Throw to second and he's out.
I think on that one right there, they were just trying to stay out of the double play. Guy at the dish isn't very fast, so anything on the ground in the infield is most likely going to be a double play. So you can't fault the team for trying to force the issue. Make sure that they create an opportunity here to score a run in this inning.
We're on that curveball, man.
Now up next for Arizona, Garrett Hampson. Now snap throw to first. Drury back in on the dive. All tied up. Top half of inning number four. Runner on the go. Got him. That ends the frame.
Hold on.
Four, now
two
right
hit and runs there. Oh,
Jones.
Shit, this is not what I want. No, no. 3-2 count. I don't want to throw a curveball.
Swing and a pop up. Foul territory for the catcher. And there's one away.
Good hard fastball up in the zone right there. They look really good coming in, but so hard to get on top of as a hitter.
Next offering is foul back. A ground ball to first, and he takes it himself for the out.
Good slider inside right there. Batter
expecting
to get there, just rolled
Snell
over
to get to.
Ball.
Here's Kike Hernandez to third. Drury.
Five. Drew five.
Throws to first, and it's a 1-2-3 inning. Dodgers go down quiet. Ready now for the fifth inning. Here's the catcher, Gabriel Moreno.
Just anywhere in the zone is bad for Gabby.
Line drive, caught!
That swing right there tells me he's seeing the ball pretty well. I know it didn't produce a hit, but he made solid contact, and that's all you're looking to do anytime you're at the plate.
So back to the top of the Arizona lineup. Corbin Carroll stands in now for the Diamondbacks. Check swing, no appeal.
No base hits in the series for him so far, and it's clearly been a rough one. You just hope he's not pressing too hard because that just compounds things. It makes the slump even longer. Never seemed to help. Never helped me.
The Dodgers bullpen with some action. Tony Gonsolin looks to be getting ready for manager Dave Roberts. In there at the knees for a strike.
Great. Yeah.
One down, base is empty. Swings through that one. It's a strikeout. And Chris, that's a way to neutralize his speed by keeping him off base.
And the defense breathes a sigh of relief because he puts pressure on everyone if he can put the ball in play. But that's how you do it. Keep him off balance, get him out of there, and deal with the next guy.
Popped up, foul territory behind the play. He's got it. And that is out number three. Back here at Chavez Ravine, John Choppy with my buddy Chris Singleton. It's set to get us started. Bottom five, Pete Crow Armstrong. The wind of the pitch. Late on that fastball.
Long guy.
Chris, we were excited to watch him pitch. This is a little more along the lines of what we were expecting performance-wise.
Yeah, Boo, great pitchers like this, you may get one opportunity in one inning to get to them, to get some runs up on the board. And if you don't take it then, you may see zeros the rest of the ballgame.
Breaking ball inside. Now two balls and a strike. Popped up. Hampson,
yeah, Hampson
under
so
it.
Fast.
That's out number two. So now here's the DH, Gavin Lux. High fly ball out into left center field. Gurriel handles the chance. We're back, and they make a change to start the sixth. The new pitcher, Tony Gonsolin.
And compared to a lot of other relievers, strikeouts have not been a big weapon for him this year, so the defense should be active.
And the right-hander deals. Spoils the two-strike pitch, and he'll see another.
A lot of foul balls.
1-2 here. On a line, base hit. So a man on base to start the inning. Here's a big power threat, Pete Alonso. Two on now.
That's the ball.
In the dirt. And the runner holds. And a 3-1 on the way. And ball four, two aboard.
Man.
Second walk of the game for him, and he's been really patient at the plate, a game plan that he's sticking to. He's just not going outside of what he's looking for up there.
In there. And so now 1-2.
Big at bat right here with an opportunity to do damage. But on the flip side, ground ball, double play, strikeout. That could get the inning back.
Line drive, base hit. And they're happy to play station to station right here. Bases loaded, nobody out. And it's Lourdes Gurriel Jr.
You should have kept Kershaw.
In the air, right field, Jones on the move to the gap. Makes the grab. Here comes the runner from third. The relay throw. Save. He moves up and a run scores on the sack fly. As they jump ahead, a run scores. Two on, one out. Down the third baseman, Brandon Drury.
Well, all eyes on the double play ball in this spot. No better way to get out of this inning.
Pitch misses, 3-2 now. Traffic on the bases with one already in here in the third and final game of the series. Over to first, and he's safe. Payoff pitch. Here goes the runner, and that'll load the bases.
You get a walk, and you get a walk. Everyone gets a walk, Boo.
And now the shortstop, Garrett Hampson. Righty delivers. Swing and a miss.
Oh.
1-2. Knocks that one away, and we'll do it again.
It was in there. I think he's going to throw a splitter down.
And a ball and two strikes. Swing and a miss at the splitter, and it's a strikeout. Gabriel Moreno stands in now for the Dbacks.
Gabby's got a shot.
The pitch. Slice to right. And that's a fair ball. One runs in, two runs are in. Headed for the plate. Relay throw home.
Oh, he's out.
In there.
Oh, okay.
It's 6-2.
His confidence level is so high. Really nice job of coming through in a big spot.
So they turn things over to the righty, Ryan Brazier.
And as relievers go, he's not a big strikeout guy. Tries to force weak contact, so command and execution are huge for him.
Could be extra bases. Around third, he will score. It's 7-2.
First hit of the
series. And that's a
two-out
double.
Seeing some good swings from him right now with consecutive extra base hits. I'll tell you, man, it's such a good feeling when you smoke a line drive into the gap like that. I mean, sure.
Well, plays made there, and that retires this up.
Feeling better about this game all of a sudden.
And now it's Mookie Betts. Now the mound for the Diamondbacks, Matt Waldron.
And you know, bullpen guys can struggle sometimes when they're called upon with big leads because it just doesn't have the same intensity as a tight game. So we'll see how sharp he is. Your mental toughness matters in situations like this as well.
And they'll do it again. The wind of the pitch. Swings and misses. And one gone.
Good stuff, man.
One down, base is empty. Wouldn't chase that time. And it's even up.
Two balls, two strikes.
Kicks and deals. And a swing and a miss at the slider in the dirt.
Damn.
Out on the drop third strike.
Joe Waldron's killing
it. Chance to strike out the side now. You talk about the benefits, the advantages of relievers who can come in and get the swing and miss, whether it's inherited runners or maybe a little jam that they get into themselves. Knowing that they can miss the bat, tell you what, that's huge and can change the ballgame.
That's towards center. Carroll makes the play, and that is that.
Feeling it much better today.
Back here at Dodger Stadium. And now here is Christian Walker. And a pitch. Swing and a miss. Activity in the bullpen for the Dodgers. J.P. Fireisen up and loosening in the pen. Grotterol also getting ready. The high heat, too much on that one.
I was late on those.
Here's the cleanup hitter for the Diamondbacks.
Yes,
Pete Alonso. Kicks and fires. Popped up. Betts settles underneath it. Two down.
He hasn't been good since I traded for him.
Two outs, base is empty. Randall Grichuk will hit next. Swing and a miss, and he was fooled.
That's again on
the
jockey.
Game's close right now, but it's not out of reach either. And these pitchers really need to put up a zero on the board just to maintain a little hope.
Pitch misses there. The count now 2-2. Here's a swing and a drive left field, and he knew it. Home run number 10 on the year, and they add to the lead. It's 8-2.
Looks like this guy was looking out over the plate, but he was ready to turn on the inside fastball. So direct to the pitch, absolutely blasted out of this ballpark.
Here's Gurriel. This one popped up. Foul ground, first base side. Nabs it, and that is that. But the solo shot stretches their lead even further. Back here in L.A., bottom of the seventh, and now the right fielder, Nolan Jones. And another ball.
You know, these Dodgers looking to string together better at bats when they have runners on, but it just hasn't happened for them yet. They've had their chances with runners in scoring position, but nobody's been able to deliver a big hit in those situations.
The Dodgers still looking for their first hit in this one. In the air, right side. And Hernandez is out.
Don't say that. Don't say that.
Stepping in, Enrique Hernandez. The pitch. Swing and a miss, and that's strike two.
One ball, two strikes.
Jones leads off first with one away. The punch out there, and two away now.
Knuckleball is fucking filthy.
Pete Crow Armstrong, the next to hit, just off the inside edge.
Two and one.
swings through that.
Two balls, two strikes.
The D-backs up big in this one here at the bottom of the seventh. And now it's 3-2.
Great RBI spot here. Just got to stay focused on the pitch. The runner will be in motion, so something in the gap should definitely score.
Oh. And there, base hit. And the bid for history is gone. Run comes across all the way from first to cut the lead.
99.
And it's 8-3. So they finally get their first hit in this one, and that puts an end to the combined no-hitter bid. Line drive, base hit. In to score is the runner from third, and it's 8-4. Runner at first with two away. And now here's the Dodgers' designated hitter, Gavin Lux. Grichik moving under this one. Makes the catch.
He's got it. He got it. We're good.
Welcome back, and a new arm on the mound to start the eighth. Brewstar Grotterol.
Definitely a guy that pounds the strike zone, makes hitters earn their way on base, and rarely gets in trouble because of free passes.
D-backs making a move for a pinch hitter, Geraldo Perdomo.
Geraldo Perdomo.
Righty to the plate. Fights that one away, still 1-2. The pitch. Little bouncer out in front of the plate. Over to first. First out in the top of the eighth. So digging in, Garrett Hampson. And he gets tied up right there.
Talk about tying a guy up. That was ugly.
And that skips in the dirt. Action in the pen down there. JP Fireisen looks to be getting ready for manager Dave Roberts. And the righty deals. That gets down for a hit. So they get a man aboard with a one-out single. Gabriel Moreno stands in now for the Diamondbacks. Right-handed reliever, runner on the go, swing and a miss.
One ball.
Throw, save. Chris, his wheels were the difference maker on that play. Just got in there.
Yeah, with Statcast's help, we see his top speed on this stolen base, and that's a big number.
Damn, Gavin. Man,
he really made his athleticism work for him on that one.
Back to the top of the lineup, Corbin Carroll stands in now for the Diamondbacks. Good chase that time. Check on the runner, and he's back in easily.
That one's easy because he has to run over there.
On the ground, right side, Betts. To first, third out. Staying in the game on defense, Geraldo Perdomo. Now he'll play third after coming into the game as a pinch hitter.
Geraldo Perdomo.
And the pitch. Swing and a ball hit out towards left center field. Gurriel handles the chance. And there's one down. And now it's Max Muncy. That pitch gets the inside corner. It's a ball and two strikes. And another ball.
It's such
an ugly
pitch.
One away near the bottom half of the eighth inning. Ground ball, Alonso.
You never know where it's going to go.
Steps on first for the out.
Now batting, catcher
Will Smith now at the plate. Next offering is in for a strike.
Oof.
The pitch. Swing and a miss. Struck him out.
Good God.
And it's a 3-up, 3-down. We're back. It's the top of the ninth. And there's a new pitcher on the mound. J.P. Fireisen.
J.P. Fireisen.
This season, so we'll see what kind of command he has.
And a pitch. Just off the outside edge. And it's 2-1.
Nasty backdoor slider. There's really nothing you can do with that if you swing at it. So that's a good take by him.
And a swing and a miss.
Circle change, I was ahead of it. Just outside, probably. Come down, maybe?
Gloves it on the dive.
Oh.
Nicely done for the out.
Fucking
now the DH spot, Christian Walker. Torrey Lovello making a move for a new bat. Jock Peterson, one out, the base is empty for him. Right-hander kicks, deals. And a swing and a miss, down on strikes.
But yeah, one and two is really a disadvantage, bro.
Getting ready to hit. Here comes a pitch. Tied him up inside with that one.
Well, pretty clear to me, he's trying to go deep right there. But you got to get a pitch that you can handle.
That misses. It's two and two.
Throwing down. Come on, come on, good pitch.
Chase that time.
Throw a good pitch. Come on.
Two outs. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And good work there.
They even swung with a contact swing right there, too.
And we're back. Now, Nolan Jones. So now 3-2. And it's ball four. He missed down low. Man at first. And now Teoscar Hernandez. Hit pretty well in the air out to center. Carroll settles under it. And
I don't have
the catch.
Anyone up in the bullpen.
And there's one down. And at the plate for the Dodgers, Kike Hernandez. Jones, the base runner at first with one out. Fouls it off, still 1-2. Oh, he hit him. And that got him pretty close.
That wasn't even close to hitting
him. 1-2, and he ends up hitting him with a pitch.
Well, the bright side is that that will help the on-base percentage a little bit, and that's a category no batter can ignore these days. OBP, OPS, well, maybe that'll ease the pain just a little bit.
Carroll grabs it on the run. So it's their last chance in this one. Freddie Freeman steps to the plate for the Dodgers. That one ripped. Tattooed and gone. His 16th homer of the year. It's 8-7. They needed that one, Singy.
Indeed they did. They've been fighting to get back into this game, and just like that, they're back in it.
And time is called for a mound visit now. Big moment in this game, so they'll talk it over. Now here is Gavin Lux. Next offering is in for a strike. The Dodgers down to their final strike. Lift it to left, and this should do it. He's got it. Ball game.
Yikes.
And
okay.
The Diamondbacks hold on to win a tight one as this one ends as a one-run ball game.
Well, you can see this team is feeling it right now. Look at this.
Walter gave him five runs.
They feel real good about this three-game series sweep, and they get it done on the road. You talk about the confidence that can produce. Tell you what, they're riding high right now. It's a nice win in this game.
They got the save, though, so that's good. Got to rest my whole bullpen. Alright, moving on to, let's just advance today real quick and see. We have an offer from the Mariners. I kind of knew it. Manta play for Sacedo. He's a 68, and Manta play is a 67. But Manta play is a lefty. Oh, this guy's also a lefty. He's a sweeper and a slider. He has the 12-6 curve. I mean, they're very similar. Sure, why not? Oh, it's July 4th. Happy birthday, America. Alright, thank you guys so much for watching. I appreciate it. We'll see you all next time.